trip to the stars. The Star Class 91 stars.
Let's make the world a better place to be. It's up to you and me.
Be a star.
Light up, up, carry.
Love, shine,
star. Loving and sharing.
Be a star.
And it's to giving.
Shining star.
That we start living.
The journey began in 1981. With the Royal Bank's Youth Savings Drive, an essay competition for fifth and sixth form students throughout Trinidad and Tobago. Today, star class teams are made up of fourth form students who organize community projects among their classmates with the help of their teachers. Over the years, students have learned how to raise funds and organize their time. They've learned to develop management skills and work together as a team. Their star class projects have taken them out of the classroom and into real life adventures, destined to create lifelong memories.
Come on, young people, it's up to you.
You gotta do the very best that you can do.
Get up and take responsibilities.
Fix a bridge,
plant trees,
build libraries.
Assist the poor in your vicinity.
Help them restore lost dignity.
You see, once you try, no matter who you are,
you can reach the sky.
Be a star!
The 1991 Star Class journey began when representatives from Royal Bank visited schools throughout the country. The message they carried to students was simple. You can help build a better tomorrow by becoming involved in community projects today. And so fourth formers began to plan their Star Class journeys. Their passports, the $5 savings accounts opened in the name of every fourth form student by Royal Bank. Students were free to chart their own journeys and to use their teachers as guides. They could choose their own goals, their own destinations, journeys to the past or journeys to the future. All they had to keep in mind is that they would have to submit a report to the star class judges. And so, the journey began.
Destroyed rapidly with boats going out there and anchoring and damaging some of the plant life on the reef itself. Our project deals with an informative brochure about what people should do and what people should not do when visiting the Boko Reef. After our project is finished, we'll be able to indicate to the people and probably get their help to preserve the reef from final destruction.
Actually, what we're doing here, we are noting the
works of the Amerindian people, artifacts and, you know, other stuff that they did. Right now we're in a midden, And a midden is basically a garbage heap, an area where the Amerindians dump their refuge. Actually we are the slope, we are the bottom of the hill. The village was more or less on top of the hill and they throw the stuff at the side of the hill. So actually we dig in here and unearthing a lot of the stuff, you know.
This Star Class project, this whole thing is really exciting, you know. It can help the history students as well as the social studies students to educate them more about the Amerindian, you know, the past. And this museum that we're building, it can help us tourist attraction, and when other people from different schools come to look at this, what Miaro has done, you know, it gives us a sense of dignity, you know, it makes us look out good and shine out, you know.
Actually, I saw this book helping the students in regards to see even class activities, for example, in history. I saw some students who were not even interested in, say, reading a chapter or anything, actually getting involved, finding works and, you know, even trying to compare them, actually motivating them to go further, you know, to get more involved. We see this here as a scholastic kind of approach in regards to, say, developing the students' mind in terms of something outside of the schoolroom, outside of the book, you know, something living. In other words, it's education and living, a living form of education.
Some of life's most memorable journeys begin in your own backyard.
This project is a model business. It is where worms produce soil, right? Here we have two pits dug, right? And we put anything in, paper, etc., you know? Anything you could think about that's biodegradable. And the worms eat it, and their castings is soil. It's good for the soil and so on, good for plants.
The number of man hours put in and the amount of money compared to the returns, it's very good.
We chose this project along the theme of employment because you all said you all wanted that, you know.
We spent about two nights to dig both of these pits, put the stuff in, and then we just bought the worms, put them in. And now all we have to do is, like, every 6 weeks, we just have to sit back, maybe come out here, if it doesn't rain someday, and just water the pits, you know. Not too much to drown the worms. We know a man who's presently doing this, and his bags of soil sell for $7. About 1 kilogram.
We embarked on the idea of rearing rabbits as a means of creating a rabbitry industry. Like, we could use it to rear for the skins, we could use it for the meat, because that is a great a delicacy all over the world. Plus, we could use it for pets. We decided for our Star Class project, since it is to create employment, we shall use this as a means of getting through
to the country, and probably somebody might take heed of this and start it.
Discovering what you have and finding a way to make it better can become an unforgettable journey.
Kumak, the local people pronounce it Kumak. It's about 12 miles from Valencia in the northern region. I see this project as a great money-making source for the country and a good thing for the people up here, as they get some sort of exposure and employment, and as most of their young people are leaving the village, well, they would get some sort of encouragement to stay and get the area back on its feet.
Attempt to beautify the forests, right? We're making it more interesting for other people. You know, a lot of people don't know the uses of forests. You know, when they come here, they usually see just, you know, what you see around here. They don't see its uses, like for shelter, its water content, you know, etc.
This was done because usually people, they just come and eat, and you know, of course there would be children, so we decided to make it a little more interesting and paint games. We have not only checkers, we have other forestry games that we have painted.
Idea is for us to tell the people why it's not good to destroy forests, and we want them to know the importance of having a forest and all the advantages of having a forest. When you have people coming together, I suppose you'll always have misunderstandings, right? But I think we've gotten over that, and we have learned to work together as a unit, and all of us are heading in one direction, and that's just to win, hopefully.
It's the people you meet who make life's journeys exciting and worthwhile. That's one valuable lesson Star Class students have learned.
Well, for me, this project was excellent. You know, it gave me a chance, like you always thought. Well, you want to do something for the community, and you know, you really want to help society in a way, and you always look for opportunities to do so, but you know, you join clubs and all that, but it doesn't really seem to help. So when I entered this project, I felt really great, because you've got an opportunity to actually help people. Helping these children is an absolutely wonderful experience, and getting to know them, because they're such loving children. You can't help but like the whole thing. You're coming here every weekend and all that. It's really thrilling.
I'll be totally honest. Saturday morning to me was really, really boring. I mean, I had nothing to do. Sitting and watch cartoons with your brother or something. But now I have the opportunity to come out and actually help people. I mean, I come and I interact with these children, and I help them make stuff, and very beautiful stuff. And it's fulfilling to me to know that I can be such a great part of society.
From a distance, we all have enough, and no one is in need. And there are no guns, no bombs, and no
I'm so happy for it. Thank you very much.
God is watching us from a distance.
Contractor gave us an estimation of $15,000, and with the money came from fundraising activities within the school and also donations from businesses in and around Point Fortin and even San Fernando. One thing we also got rid of was calling this place a poor house. We tried not to get out of our minds and call it a senior citizens' home instead of a poor house.
From a distance, I just cannot comprehend what all this fighting is for. From a distance,
Cultivated crops that we would in turn teach the special children from the school down the road, just how to market the crops and just how to cultivate and grow them. We thought that it would not have been successful because, you know, everybody thinks about the children as being retarded, and we realize that they themselves know more than we do in some areas.
We have had a relationship with the people. We've gotten to know the people. We help them to realize that they should not think of this as a last resort. We're not going to stop here. We're going to continue and try and do as much as we can do to better this place.
From a distance.
Sometimes unforeseen obstacles get in the way of the best planned journeys, as students from QRC discover.
Most of the fellows, right, realize, well, going to the beach, like, especially like Tarico, right? If you get something to eat, you have to go all the way down to Maracas. So we decided, well, we wanted to do something about that. So we decided to do this as our project and come up here. And put in an eating facility and a dining area. During the Easter vacation, was completely demolished by vandals and campers who came here. Well, we would like to rebuild the canteen because the person we employed has nowhere else to sell our stuff, right? So we decided we'll repair the canteen, refurbish it, and make it even better.
Of course, the most important aspect of any journey is what you do with the information you collect along the way.
President Saddam Hussein is seeking to reserve his Gulf War military flight by deploying air power.
And I say, well, I want to do this, and I could get the children to do it, so it's no problem, and we will do it. And, well, home was like, you didn't have anything to do. And once after school, come and express, work, go home, sleep, get up, school, work. Express supported us all the way because, you know, they gave us encouragement. They told us, even when Miss Batiste told us to go and look for stories and we didn't have any, she said, y'all, it have stories everywhere. Y'all can't find a story. And then she carried us outside and we interview a vagrant. And she said, look, y'all got a story. What y'all tell me about, y'all have a story.
One day in elective, we were discussing about effects on the ozone layer by man. And then we decided that Cyrotex, when it was incinerated, it gave off gases that affects the ozone layer. And then we decided, why don't we make something with it and use it for the good of man instead of it destroys the earth. So then our form teacher gave us some chemicals and we brought Cyrotex and we started to experiment. And then we came up with this sticky substance while mixing it with the Cyrotex. And then we tried it on paper and we found that it was a good adhesive. We tried it on shoes and vinyl and stuff like that, and it is very good.
The students so far have been quite enthusiastic about the whole project because they have been making quite a lot of money because our raw material is free, which is styrofoam and some waste plastic like pen barrels and plastic forks and plastic spoons and so on. It takes about $30 to buy chemicals, which is the only thing we purchase because we also get the bottles free from San Fernando and Port of Spain General Hospital. And you find that with a $30 purchase of a gallon of chemicals, we're able to make about the same amount of adhesive. And we make about $180 from such a purchase.
And we are using the money for our own use because in these hard times, parents have to stretch their dollar to send their children to school. So we will earn our own money and put less stress on our parents' pockets.
The plan here was draining the flooding that exists here during the rainy season and beautifying the area. The idea came from the boys and they wanted to do something on this Star Class project. The information they get on our programs in terms of cooperation, camaraderie, understanding the functions of leadership and supporting leadership. In terms of on this project here, we have boys who are like supervisors on the projects and the others are required to support them, obey them, do, you know, move to the instructions and things like that.
From this project we'll be doing here, anybody who passing and decide and seeing that then could give them the encouragement, but look, they're watching we as youths who lost them, you understand? But we ain't lost yet because we still have a chance in life and we could become out there and be big winners, you understand? And if them watch on as we doing here, them could do the same because them still out there, them had the opportunity more than we. Yeah, so we had a wait on the opportunity, but them have it at hand. And if them learn something from what we doing here, them could them can have it as the same. Because they say, you win or you lose is by the way you choose, you understand? So if them choose to go on that road, they could win, you understand?
And when the journey is complete, it's celebration time.
It is very obvious that there are no limits to your creativity, to your resourcefulness, and to the extent of your pride in yourselves, in your schools, and in your communities. I feel, however, that the most noteworthy attributes of the Royal Bank Star Classes have been the demonstrations of care, empathy, genuine concern for the welfare and well-being of others. We are proud of Star Class and look forward to many more years of worthy examples of community work and nation building.
Bring down the power of love, I say. Bring down the power. The power of love, I say, is the greatest power. Stop hell and damnation. Bring down the power. Love to heal a nation is the greatest power.
Chose as its theme this year self-employment, and students set out to create employment. We saw projects that ranged from employment agencies to export agencies, from books on the environment to magazines on our country, from one-man businesses to cooperatives. The variety was there. We scrutinized 118 reports from 69 schools in Trinidad and Tobago, representing the work of approximately 5,000 fourth form students who in 5 months were able to complete their projects at a cost of nearly 300 $100,000. Once again, star classes performed with excellence. So excellent were your performances that again, winners were decided by a fraction of a point. Please take this excellence back into your classrooms, into your families, and into the society. We came up with winners, but you didn't make it easy for us. Once again, good luck.
You are the one who's led me to the sun. Oh, how could I know that I was lost with you?
The star class of 91, and this award goes to, first let me read the project, it was a magazine. And it says it's a success story, and the school is Success Laventil Composite, and the student to receive it, Trisha Burrows.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody.